show dates or a newsletter, something that keeps connecting with the people. So then my business to a more professional level.
Okay. That's what's up. Because I think that's very important nowadays that artists have to learn, because, you know, 20 years ago, the artist just needed to be the artist.
Yeah.
They didn't need to know how to, you know, brand themselves because the label was
and
there.
That's so important now. You have to learn to brand. And I'm still learning. I know everything. I'm still learning. Trial and error. Some things I learned slower. And I've appreciated the slow process. Mm-hmm. Everything had to be microwave. We live in that society. Everything has to be right now.
It's the gratification right now.
But I've learned to, you know, calm myself down. Because I've definitely, you know, get anxious. And I wanted to put Food 2 out in the summer.
Yeah, everybody wants to put a project out in the summer.
I was ready to kill the summer. I'm like, yeah, but I'm glad I didn't, because I took some time. And I added some tracks. The last track I added to Fool 2 was What I Want. That's the very last one I added.
Wow.
And that was one of the best ones on it.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's the last one I added. The very, very last one. Some of the late editions was For You. And people liked that one. I was like, wow. That one actually getting really good response on the West Coast. Shout out to my dude DJ Stool, who holds me down in Arizona. A lot of people love that track. So it was like, all right, cool. I did the intro over like 3 times. So it's just the slow process. I definitely appreciated it more.
Now, I listen to your music. I can't say I hear a very direct line of influences.
Okay.
Where do you draw your influences from?
It's all over the place, man. It's all over the place. I'm going to say, of course, Hov. Mm-hmm. That's, I think any New York artist is going to say Hov.
Particularly Brooklyn.
It's Hov. Like, it's the God MC. Like, we know Rakim is the God MC. I know you hip hop purists. I'm going to say, yeah, Rakim is, you know. Rakim is not my time, though.
Right.
Hov is my time. And Hov is God MC to me. So, of course, we can go with Hov. We'll definitely go with Big. Like, just the, I'm a fat nigga, but I'm still fly, whatever. Like, I'm still take your bitch type nigga. Like, Big was that nigga. So, like, you cannot deny.
Now, are you that? Because I watched you at, it was like 2 shows. And I watched you, bro. I was like, hold on. Because when I heard Dapper Don, I was like, I didn't know what you looked like yet. So, I mean, this sounded like some, like, I'll Be Sure.
Oh, wow.
You know.
Shout out to Hannah Brown, nigga.
You know what I mean? Maybe the unibrow light skin nigga. Who knows? I don't know. And he showed up to the show, and I'm like, yo, this nigga look like he about to fuck everything up in here.
Yeah, I try.
But then I hear the music, and then, you know, and I see the way you're moving. You're a very smooth kind of guy. So,
I try.
Is that your persona pretty much? Because that's what I see. Like,
pretty laid back.
Yeah.
Pretty laid back. I like to have fun. I like to laugh. I'm definitely like to make jokes and stuff. Like, I've given myself like maybe an hour or two. I can joke on Twitter every day.
Yeah.
Like, it humanizes me a little bit. Like, yeah, I'll promo all day long, but now it's also just taking my brand more seriously. Not going too overboard. Like, I'll make jokes about my peoples and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, you know, a little here and there stuff that I can laugh at and make myself feel a little at ease and calm. But yeah, that's definitely one of my things. That's when I saw him Big. Like, mm-hmm. Big was definitely like a smooth nigga. He was a jokester with his people, but he was also a beast artistically. So that's one thing I always have seen in people that have known him personally and, you know, spoke of him and just kind of thought he was just like a, you know, quote unquote teddy bear. You know what I mean? Pause, you know, but you know what I mean? So I just figured like, you know, this is me. I'm a fun person with my people. I'm fun. Like, I try to be professional and everything, but so gotta have fun, man. You gotta enjoy the ride. You cannot like be uptight in this ride.
Right.
So definitely being one of my influences. Heavy D, mm-hmm. You know, that was a smooth. That was like the patriarch of the big niggas.
I don't think he gets enough credit though. Like,
unfortunately, he doesn't, especially production wise.
Yeah,
especially production wise. You know what I mean? As an artist, he had a great run as an artist, even a great run as a producer. People leave him out.
Yeah,
unfortunately, but What a Bad Head, definitely one of my influences. I'm gonna go with Scarface is in my top 5. I debate that all day long with anybody.
Not a common one, but a good one.
Face Mob is definitely one of the illest ever. Like, say E40, even y'all just love slandering E40. E40's dope. Fuck yeah. But then, like, also to the person that's, anybody that knows me knows that this person's on the same level as Hov to me, and that's the Dream. Dream is God. I don't care if nobody says to me Tyrion's Nash is fucking God. I don't care. Y'all like The Weeknd. I don't care. Y'all like Bryson Tiller. All these niggas is the Dream sons. All of them. I don't care. Nobody else says that.
What? It could go either way, right? Because we're not gonna go into that debate. It could go either way. Because you kind of could. You could put Bryson Tiller
in that category.
Tory Lanez. Right. You could kind of put them in the Dream.
That chick's tape is fire. Tory Lanez. You know, but these niggas.
This nigga flipped.
The Dream is that nigga though. The Dream been that nigga.
Nah, he has. He has.
The Dream been that nigga.
But you also gotta put him in the family tree of the nigga R. Kelly. You have to.
Oh, definitely. Kelly's one of my definite influences musically, because of course I do both the singing and the rap shit. So Kel's definitely an artist that, you know, I definitely admire a lot. Is Marsha Ambrosius.
Dope.
Definitely admire, even just from Flowetry days. Like, just her painting game is so mean. Like, people understand, like, the songs that y'all love so much, she wrote them.
Yeah. Even on
Yes.
Michael Jackson.
She wrote Butterflies.
Butterflies.
And it was actually a demo of theirs. Mm-hmm. Michael loved the record. Like, I want that. You want to tell Michael Jackson no?
Of course. I want that.
You're going to tell Michael Jackson no? Like, mm-hmm. If Michael Jackson wanted Riot Music, I'm like, look, where the fuck do we go to record this shit over? Like, here, you can have this right now.
I was going to say, you didn't name him. Is he an influence of yours at all?
MJ, as far as artistically, hell yeah. Who wouldn't have him as an influence? Ray Charles of influence him. As far as artistically and business, a lot of people forget that Ray Charles was one of the first artists to own all of his masters.
Right.
That was in his deal. Like, okay, I worked to get this popping. I'm popping up the legs and go, I want my masters.
Now, that should be a lesson to all of you rappers who can actually see, right? Ray Charles couldn't even see.
See, like, look, I want my masters.
And he owned all his masters. So, it's not impossible. Own your shit. Stand
as far as, I also do songwriting too, so mm-hmm. Brian Michael Cox is a definite, influence of mine, especially when I'm writing. I just try to use all those different things. I know I'm probably going to shut up, but it's so much music that I'm influenced by.
So there's no way to really pinpoint as far as, okay.
I mean, you can hear in my music, I guess you can feel that I listen to a lot. And, like, a couple of my friends, they do make fun of the whole Tyrion's Dad thing, because I definitely listen to Dream a lot, and even when I'm composing my own shit, I just love the Dream style, his writing style. Of course, everyone knows he's an amazing writer.
I can hear
it
in your music.
But just the simplistic melodies that stay with you.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm in love with you, baby, and I want you to know that I'm hooked on your body.
Nah, it's just simple shit that's like, yo, shit's fire. Like, so it's just real, it's real, real different with me, man. Like, I'm not the hugest Nas fan, but I respect his work.
Always.
I think Nas is one of his best tracks. Like, if you ask a Nas fan what's his best track, they'll probably not say the same thing I say, because I'm more of an outsider on that end. Mm-hmm. But to me, his best track is Rewind. It's the concept. The concept of Rewind.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. To sit there and really artistically write a song backwards. It flows together. It makes sense. It's not all over the place.
It's just a story.
And you still tell a story in a manner like, dude, this is some fucking real shit. You can't not respect that. It's impossible to not respect that. And, Pun was ill with the
Capital Punishment.
There's different, there's elements of verses.
Mm-hmm.
And I think there was no one better at internal multisyllables than Big Pun.
I don't know how he did it.
I don't know how
he did it. He's like 600 pounds, no disrespect.
And he would effortlessly do it.
Yeah.
But a lot of people don't put him in their top, whatever, because it was unfortunately he had a short-lived career. But you cannot, you know, not say that man's not somehow an influence, because, you know, it's just...
I think he's a big influence. Writing he's talking about Hispanic rappers right now.
Yeah, and then, like, you know, you have, like, the rappity rap niggas, and that's great. I don't view myself as one, because that's just not my lane, but I enjoy it. Like, you may have, like, I have colleagues that are just, are like that, and I sit there, and I like listening to their work, because they do something that I don't do, and it's still amazing to listen to. Like, Work Smith is fucking lyrically retarded.
You know, I got to say, I first seen Wordsmith and Trey Pizzy at
Smith a Paper House shit, Entertainment it's show. Retarded.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, and you know, shout out to my man Push Montana. You know what I mean? Niggas look like you gotta What's listen going, to Push. Wait, hold man.
On. What's going on with Push? Because
Push working.
Okay. Because Push was steadily. He had a crazy buzz. I think in like maybe 2012, 2013.
Push out the Wing Low back in the studio too. So okay. I was about to get real out here, 2016.
Those are niggas I want to see on it. Niggas is working.
Niggas is definitely working. You know, and the person who I definitely got to view their writing process. I know this is about me, but I definitely like giving up to New York, man. Cause I'm just so proud of my city right now. I'm so proud of being a part of everything that's going on. Cause I feel good. I can set my chest out a little bit. Like, yeah, I'm a part of this too. Like, yeah. And someone that I got to see their writing process, and I'm like, yo, this nigga, yeah, he's a real deal, Manolo.
Yeah.
Manolo's writing process is real funny, but like, man, shit.
Yeah.
Like how Jay would say, like, he does a Rain Man, like, nigga just sits. It'd be a room full of niggas. I witnessed this shit. We was in a studio in Atlanta. Niggas just room full of niggas. Mm. He's doing the beat going. He's doing his thing. Nigga we're in the booth. This nigga is retarded with hooks. Like, with hooks, that nigga is. Talking earlier, like, oh man, Absol, man, Absol was fucking. When I first started listening to Absol, like I said it was the Wanting, and that track was so fucking ill to me. I'm like, yo, this
the track, the fucking video.
Nigga had the fucking suit on. Right. And then we all did a show together a couple years back. The Riddles on the Rise. We did the Eminem when I don't know if you know Club Nova in Brooklyn when it was Venus.
Yeah,
and we it's fucking been like we years sold years. Venus the fuck out. That bitch the fuck out. Me, Absol, NRP, Push, Wink Lope. Troy Ave came did a feature on this shit with Wink and Push and shit. The town. The town's still a crazy ass record.
Yeah.
But it was a good fucking night, you know. So for me, I'm like, look, I'm just happy to be a part of this. I'm happy to be in the conversation. Just some artists, you gotta really that's one of the things you gotta strive to do. Just to be in the conversation. One thing a lot of people just fall off doing is like, yo, I'm nice. Cool, you nice. But do 10 more people think you nice? But you're gonna get people online that's gonna say you trash or that. I've had it happen. Like,
yeah, that's true.
You know, it's gonna happen. I've definitely had it happen. And if you let that shit fuck with you, it's gonna show in your product. Mm-hmm. So you gotta use that shit like, all right, cool, I'm trash. But 20 more people right here saying I'm not.
Right.
So year one to my 20 is not going to affect me. It used to affect me. It used to bother me. Because what people don't understand, and I think I'm glad I'm doing an interview, I need to explain the creative process of an artist, because it's easy to get online and say, yo, keep your mixtape on my fucking mentions, or don't spam. Stop spamming people's music. That's another thing, too. Yeah, I got artists that I stopped doing that because I'm fucking up for everybody else. But what you gotta understand is it's such a conversational joke now that people who make mixtapes or make projects are artists and don't understand that you an artist is the most transparent person you can be, because you're presenting yourself to the public to basically be crucified. It's like, here, this is me, pick me apart, rip me apart, and judge me. That's what you're basically signing up for.
Right.
So the fact that in your creative process, when you're really creating a project, and for me, it took me a year to do Food Too. So imagine all the things you see online in a year, and all the things that trolls may say to you in a year, and you have to still block that shit out, and go in the studio and do your job, and create, and go do shows with a happy face on and fucking rip the fucking show and shit and do all these things. People understand the creative process is one of the most scary places to be because you second guess yourself. You wonder if you're good enough. You wonder if this is good enough. And you start doing a lot of wondering and soul searching, and you think that, like, okay, should I be doing this?
Right.
And it's a lot of that in the creative process. It's the great part is after, mm-hmm. where you release it and people like it and you feel relieved. So imagine carrying an anxiety on your back for like a whole year, and then you release it, and then it's like everybody likes it, so you can breathe now. Mm-hmm. you can breathe. But when you're in it, it's like you're unsure of yourself sometimes because it's like, damn, this motherfucker is ruthless out here.
Now, do you feel like, because I remember we were talking off camera, and you were saying, you know what it's like to you know, when you're waiting to get put on, and you want
that look,
that public acceptance, and you know, you said you start mad tweeting, and did you ever feel like there was a point that you wanted to just kind of say, fuck it, and
yo,
just
my
walk
fucking,
away?
My drafts on Twitter, Jesus. The shit that I don't tweet is way, way worse than the shit I do tweet. Like, it's times that maybe I've gone to my drafts just to vent and write a whole bunch of shit, and I just save it and leave it alone and don't tweet it.
Nah, Lord knows we all been there. I've been
there. And it's
times.
Like, you think, because, like, you know, and it's disgusting to hate on the next person. Mm-hmm. It's a disgusting trait. Jealousy is a female shit. Like, niggas shouldn't be jealous of no man. You just gotta get yourself to work to the point where you can get where that man is at. So you may see all your homies around getting put on, everybody, you know, popping off crazy, or maybe, you know, same light that you felt you should have gotten by now.
Yeah.
And it may not necessarily be your fault totally. Mm-hmm. You know, it just may not be your time. It may be the people you had around you. It may be the people that you had working with you that wasn't really working your product correctly. It may be you, your product. It wasn't just ready yet.
Right.
So it's just a lot of frustrations that go into it. And you're like, fuck, like, when is my turn? You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Because like I said, you know, you see your man who probably had a loose, like hustle on the street, or he's working a fucked up job. But like 3 weeks later, he's flying out to LA to do some tracks with fucking like Dre or some shit. Or like he put on a big show, or he on a big stage, or he getting all them good looks now that you wanted. And then, you mad because you're getting the fuck up for work on Tuesday. You're like, fuck, I don't want to be here. I know what I want to do, mm-hmm. but I know what I got to do at the time. It's frustrating.
Yeah.
It's frustrating. And the frustration can turn into misplaced anger. And that's what a lot of the people don't get. And I really empathize with artists because I understand where some of the angry tweets come from because it's just misplaced frustration. But people who don't understand necessarily will just say you're crying. And they're saying you're bitching, and they're saying you're complaining. So what I've learned to do is keep my mouth shut. Keep my mouth shut and work. Because that's all, at the end of the day, is what matters, is you working.
Yeah.
You could complain all the fuck you want, but you gotta close that app.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta put that phone down, and you get the fuck to work.
Especially because, I mean, Twitter's the biggest gift and a curse, right? Because, man. I mean, with Twitter, it's genius.
You get sucked in the black
Twitter. Yeah, you got these characters, limited amount of characters, you could express whatever the fuck you want, but at the same time, them shits stay with you forever. Like, it's nothing,
it really
you can't
does.
Get away from that shit.
It really does, yeah. And like, especially if you're building yourself, you're branding yourself, you have to really be careful of what you put out in the atmosphere.
Yeah.
Of what you put out, because it represents you, because you can't sit here and say a whole bunch of crazy shit. And then the next 5 minutes later, like, look, hey, look at my project. I'm like, oh, fuck it. You know what I mean? Like, a friend of mine, who, she no longer lives up here, but one of my best friends, Shay, to tell me that what you want to be known for, you want to be known for the funny fat nigga, or you want to be known as the artist. And it took a while, it took some learning, some bumps and bruises to know that what she was always saying was ringing true.
Right.
And it fueled my work ethic now. Like, I want to be known as the artist, and that's happening. So it transitioned from, yo, that's a funny nigga, to the artist. Like, yo, it's going to be some dope shit.
Mm.
Because it had to be that. I had to make a decision. Do I want to be funny, or do I want to be an artist? you'll get called serious or you uptight or not maybe uptight. It's just I don't play like that no more.
Right.
Because I take what I'm doing very seriously and I'm not gonna put all this fucking money into this shit just to fucking keep some links. Nah, like who the fuck really in they right now, people understand. I don't know, I can't speak for everybody, but who the fuck in their right mind sits there and invests? Do you understand? A project, just to put a fucking album together, studio time, like, depending on where you go. Let's just say the median is like 60 hour or whatever. So you're going to put close to maybe 4 or 5 stacks into making a project to fucking sit there and just tweet links all day? Who the fuck in their right mind does that? If that's the end all be all for you, then that's crazy.
Right.
Then you might as well give us the fuck up and go do something else. Go do something else. Who the fuck really, that's like their mindset for now, like, oh, I'm going to tweet these links all day. No. The links is part of it, definitely, because you're raising a global awareness, because the internet is global. You can't sit here and say it's following me on Twitter or whatever. So it was cool, like, when we took a picture of all that shit, just to see that. Little things fuel me, you know what I mean? The wins are always great. It's always great when a good publication posts you. It's always, but word of mouth is so dope because that's when you know you're connecting with people.
Right.
And for somebody that lives on the other side of the world to be like, yo, I like your stuff, that's great. So it's not like the end all be all is not just to, you know, tweet some links to get some retweets. Retweets are dope. I tell people all the time, retweets are great. I love it. I appreciate them. I would prefer listens over them because I want you to hear the product. I want you to see what I'm putting out there. And you can tell me if you don't like it or not. That's okay. You are entitled to your opinion.
Right.
So, for somebody to sit there and put all this money into just wanting to put some links is crazy. That's crazy. You got to be outside. You got to go.
You got to touch the people.
You got to touch the people.
You
got to
go to shows.
You have to. Even if it's not your show. And like I've tried to say a couple of times. And in the past, yeah, whatever, if I haven't made it out to your event, is really not on purpose. It's just that I was really busting my ass working and, you know, actually legally doing a company is not the fucking, you know, most easiest thing to do, and it's very time consuming. You know, not just for me to sit there and say book company music all the time and just to make it a cool name to put online, but like to actually, I have to file taxes with this shit now. I have to fucking, you know, I have official imprint, you know, I have my incorporation papers. So it was just process, and when you understand this, that's why I feel for artists sometimes, because I think we get it horribly, man. We get it horribly because there's a crop of those that don't do it the right way and make it annoying for the ones who are really doing this the right way.
Right.
And you'll have artists that'll just sit there and spam mentions all day, and that's not the way to get heard by anybody. And you'll see the quote unquote tastemakers say this all the time, but then you'll still do it. So it's like either you saying fuck them, I don't want to pay attention, or you're not taking your shit seriously to know that you want to be taken seriously. Build a rapport with people. Hey, I'm this, I'm that, this is what I do. If you don't mind, hey, listen to that.
Trust me, they're not taking it seriously because at least 100 times a week in my mentions, I get an artist spamming me, sending me a link, check out the video.
I have a question. Do you have a click on any of the tracks?
I'll tell you why. Because most times, when you're looking at tweets, I look at tweets in passing. Like, I'm looking at tweets, I'm scanning through Twitter. I'm horrible at Twitter. Like, I'll be honest. Like, I use Twitter to promote your guys' music and stuff like that. But when you spamming me, you hitting me, check out my video. A couple times I'd say, all right, here's my submissions email. Hit me on the email.
You don't send it.
Nah, never do. So when you don't send me your music, I say, all right, you're not serious about this shit. You don't really want to be featured.
Crazy.
I get submissions from you. I get submissions
That's
from
crazy.
Other artists.
Like, I think it's you just have to take the same amount of time you took to spam all them people, right? You could have took an equally amount of time. This is what I do every time before release. I block off an amount of time, about a good 5 hours, 6 hours, that I can sit. Some snacks, some Pepsi, whatever, some Henny, whatever the fuck.
Food.
Put me in, food. You know, I get some wings and shit. I have a movie going. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I sit at my computer and I will do my submissions. And I'll go through, you know, my contact list.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, please BCC, artists BCC, please don't be one of them, because these bloggers will definitely make fun of you. Please don't be the guy that
bloggers are sensitive. They don't like that shit.
Please don't be the guy that puts everybody in the recipient list. Not a BCC. But anyway, I'll block off that amount of time, and I'll sit at the computer, and I'll do it.
Right.
You know, and it's a diligence. Yeah, some going to bounce back, some change emails, but this is what's happening. You build up your contact list. You keep getting these contacts. You keep getting submission emails from here. You Google submission emails.
Right.
You know, search on Twitter, submission emails, and you find what you need to find. And instead of just going to spam people, it works better that way, and you get posted, and more people will hear you.
Yeah.
Rather than just throwing links to people's mentions, and I see it too many times to be the guy that wants to do it.
Right.
Now, maybe I'll add somebody like, hey, you know, check it out, and then they ask me for the link, I'll put the link in their mentions. But I say it's on the timeline, you know, and that's why I will spam my own timeline. I don't promote a fuck on my own timeline.
I mean, that's what it's for.
That's what it's there for.
Yeah.
But, you know, I feel for artists next time because we get a bad rep from the ones that aren't doing it correctly, and it's like a social joke to be an artist. To be a creative, one of the best things you could be in this world, because you have a mind that can take a thought and transform it into something that can be heard. And what people would think like, it's a joke until you pop.
Right.
Then they're a joke no more. Anybody want to be your friend? And all the girls want to get pussy. Like, it's like, you know, you can even mildly pop, and then, like, you know, they don't already.
Now, do you feel right now that you know a lot of people that are looking at your artistry as a joke or looking at it like...
No.
No?
And I'm glad that I've gone from just being a cool guy that knows how to make people laugh to being taken seriously for my art.
That's what's up, man. I wish you much success. As a matter of fact, is FooTube available for download just besides SoundCloud, or can we get it on iTunes?
It'll be on iTunes in a few days. Apple just takes forever with this shit. So I got antsy and said, fuck it, let me put it on SoundCloud. So I was really waiting for Apple. That's what the whole release day was waiting for Apple. I don't fuck y'all doing over here, because I guess Future done fucked y'all up. And he made y'all business with him. Everybody was sitting there backlog. I don't know what the fuck's going on over there. But it's going to definitely be on Apple. It's going to be on Spotify, Amazon, all that shit. So it's definitely going to be there. But, put the fuck up for my people, please. Thank you.
Definitely. Go get that. I'll definitely make sure.
Food Tools out now, though, but you can definitely get on SoundCloud. You know, follow me on Twitter at DAPADON, Instagram at DAPADON718. I tweet this shit every day, all day, religiously. It's a great fucking album. I stand behind my product. I'm like fucking Frank Lucas, you know what I mean? Like Pepsi. I stand behind my product. I guarantee it. You want like Food Tools. Play Fools with your girl, you can play it for yourself, you can play it for your mom, play it for everybody. Everybody can play Fools too.
Valentine's Day is coming up. Make sure you get that in your
playlist. Ain't no Valentine's Day for me this year.
Not for you. But you the ladies,
bro. Listen to me. I established this shit already.
Okay.
No, the dream is doing a show on Valentine's Day. Unless you like the dream, there's no Valentine's Day. There's not happening. Tyrius the God Nash is doing a fucking show in New York. Harley Tours. It's this thing. Dream Harley Tours. So, there's no Valentine's Day. Unless them, I'm doing back.
So,
like,
so
like
you got tickets already?
Oh, you think I did?
So, you got the extra ticket for the lady that want to roll?
Nah.
Damn. So, ladies, you got to get your own ticket.
If you hit me and let me know you like the dream, and you listen to Food too. We ain't doing no tickets if you don't listen to Fool Tool. Fuck that. You got to tell me like 3 songs of that shit. So, nah. That's the only way.
I'm flying back in the
same day or something.
You can make that into a contest.
Probably could.
3 songs of the Fool that they like. For that. Lyrics.
Just sit around you for a couple hours. I like you enough for that. So, I gotta be able to sit around you for a couple hours. You know what I mean? Then, like, you gotta be able to deal with me being an obnoxious fan. Like, because I'm really fucking, like, it's only 2 people I stand for is Hove and The Dream. So you gotta be able to deal with that shit. For like,
so you gonna be singing the song.
Hell fucking, you gonna be listen. Hell yeah. That, That Tyrion do purple kisses. I'm singing the whole fucking song. The whole show. Look, if you don't like the dream, you gotta like the dream, and you gotta like Dapper Dawn. So, you don't like either one of them two, just don't ask me for the fucking ticket. I'll get you a ticket, but don't ask me for the ticket.
And you gotta be smashing at the end of the night. I said it for him.
I'm a gentleman. We ain't gotta be smashing at the end of the night. We have a good, respectable evening. Listen to food too. That's more important than pussy. So, yeah.
Listen to food too. But if you also want to throw some pussy,
I'm not.
You're more than welcome, right? Okay.
I'm more discretionary with the box. I used to be real wild. I'm more discretionary now. So you gotta have some criteria before we do that now. So I'm building a brand.
You're definitely gonna save that for another interview. But I just want to say that I love Futu.
Thank you, sir.
I think it's dope.
I love Rotten Apple TV. Always supporting. I appreciate.
Thank you, man.
You're
gonna continue to push your music. Your shit is dope. Keep delivering the music.
Definitely.
Oh, nigga, we gonna link up again.
My man.
Gonna do it.
And we gotta do Food 2 Live, too, so we gonna put that in the works, though. You know what I mean?
Definitely. We gonna work on that.
Got the full band out, all that shit. That's definitely gonna be in the works. Trust me.
You heard it here. You go to Chris from the Rotten Apple TV. We drinking wine. We had no Henny today, but the wine is good.
I want my gentleman shit today.
It's your boy Chris signing out.